When Premier Doug Ford slashed the number of Toronto City councillors from 44 to 25, his decision was met with protests and outrage. Well, it's been about 6 months since these 25 councillors took office, so we asked them what it's been like working with a smaller council. Apparently, the meetings have been about 2 hours shorter, but their workloads have increased substantially.
We are totally flooded with phone calls. Our ward has doubled. We have over 100,000 constituents.
We did hire additional staff as well, which makes it a little easier.
It's busier. There was councillors that they say, well, you know, I had my Friday afternoons off. There's no such thing as off anymore.
It's a different kind of job. So, you know, you now have double the constituents. For example, I have, you know, doubled the business improvement areas that I have. I have 14 of them, plus residence associations, plus, you know, the development meetings. So it's a lot busier locally. We rely a lot more on our staff, our teams, to get involved in our community.
The number of case files that I'm getting is increasing, and that's just because the population has increased to such a large degree. The intake's gotten larger. I haven't seen anything like this in quite some time.
Generally speaking, customer service declines when you take away political representation.
Unfortunately, we have 2-3 meetings in any given evening, sometimes it means we're not able to send the right staff person that can answer those questions. And we struggle with that. We do our best.
For us, we have to adapt to that, not being able to go to a meeting. I still resent that.
I think people want to have access to their counselors, but I also know that the best councillors want to have access to their communities in a way that they're there to work with them.
The same has been true, in the mayor's office, that there's a sort of, because of the fact that the councillors are harder pressed, we're getting more calls here from people who are seeing if we can help them in the mayor's office, even though I'm representing the same number of people as I did before.
So you manage 3 BIAs. What has the past 6 months been like with a smaller council?
I have to be very strategic and very focused when I am with the councillors, because their time is valuable. Definitely the face-to-face time that you do get with a councillor is significantly reduced. Had there been 44 or 47 councillors, then things would probably move twice as fast.
Now, the Ford government said that cutting city council would save $25 million over 4 years. We checked with city staff and they actually told us that the council budget went up $1 million this year, and that's because these councillors had to hire additional staff to keep up with their constituents. However, if they had stuck with a 47-member model, then that number would have been up $3.5 million. So they did save approximately $2.5 million this year. Ahead on City News, we have a ton of social media reaction to share with you. It has been almost exactly 6 months since these 25 councillors were elected. And earlier in the show, we told you a little bit about how they've adapted to working on a smaller council. They say that meetings have definitely gotten a bit shorter, a couple hours shorter, but their workloads have grown exponentially. The demand from constituents has grown because their wards have doubled in size. So we also put out a question on social media. We asked you how this new council may or may not have impacted your life. So Justin said, I haven't been able to get one thing done. Previously, if you called, it was done the same day or next day. As a City of Friends of Parks volunteer, it's almost impossible. I'm sure the summer will bring more things I can't get done with no one to get answers from. Randy says, Doug made a good choice. Smaller is better. Mark says, this is costing us more, which isn't surprising since we now need to hire more public workers to fill in the gaps that these councillors did. We Torontonians decide what level of service we demand from our city council, not the premier, unless he wants to take over the whole city. And Eamon says, I don't agree to how this went down or how much it was cut. There is less support for when something needs to be done. Councillors are strapped between city business and supporting their constituents. It makes no sense for a city of this size. So a big range of opinions on social media. It's clear that not only are councillors trying to adapt to this new reality, but so are Torontonians.